Hi students, good morning. This is P. Venkateswarlu, lecturer in physics, ABR Junior College, Tattupoli. Now we have discussed the new Cartesian sign convention to solve the problems based on mirror equation. 1 by f is equal to 1 by u plus 1 by v. So what are the new Cartesian sign conventions to be followed to solve the problems? So the first one is, so we know the concave mirror and the different important definitions in the case of two types of mirrors. Let us observe, P is the pole, F is the focus, and C is the center of curvature of the concave mirror. Coming to the, what are the new Cartesian sign convention? The first one is, all the distances are measured from the pole of the mirror, whether it is convex mirror, concave mirror. So the first sign convention is, all the distances are measured from the pole of the mirror. From the pole of the mirror. What is pole? P. So we measure all the distances. That means object distance, image distance, or height of the object, or height of the image. So these are all measured from the pole or center of the pole, which can be act as the origin in the case of coordinate system. So this is the first sign convention. Coming to the second one. So the distances measured in the direction of the incident light are taken as positive. Here we are observing that the incident light is always takes place from left to right. If the distances are measured in the direction of the incident light, so these distances are taken as positive. So the distances measured in the direction of positive incident light is always taken as positive. So that is the second point. So the second one is, the distances measured in the same direction of incident light. The distances measured in the same direction of incident light should be taken. Should be taken as positive. So while we are moving from left to right in the direction of incident light, then all the distances are measured positive if and only if the distance are taken in the direction of the incident light. So this is the direction of incident light. We are measuring the distance in the same direction, that can be taken as positive. Coming to the third point. So third sign convention is, if the distances are measured in the opposite direction of the incident light, that distance are taken as negative. Suppose the direction of the incident light is from left to right. Suppose if you measure the distances in the opposite direction of the incident light, so these distances are taken as negative. So this should be equal to negative, right? Then we can write the third sign convention. What is the third one? The distances measured. The distances measured in the opposite direction of incident light instant light, or taken as negative. So the distance is measured in the opposite direction of incident light or taken as negative. So the light is moving from left to right. Suppose if you want to measure the distance in the opposite direction of the incident light, these distances are to be taken as negative. And the fourth one is the height of the objects which are lying above and perpendicular to the principal axis. So the line which is connecting center of curvature focus is called as principal axis. So this is called principal axis. So the heights above the principal axis which are perpendicular to it are measured as positive. So this can be taken as positive. So heights are distances which are above the principal axis and normal to it is taken as positive. So we can write the fourth one. The distances in bracket we can write heights. So the distances measured above the principal axis, above the principal axis and perpendicular to it. So the distances measured above the principal axis perpendicular to it is taken positive. So this is the representation of the heights measured above the principal axis which are normal to its surface is always taken as positive. Then we can take the next one. Again, the heights or the distances below the principal axis and normal to its surface is always taken as negative. And the next one is, you can write it, the heights. So the heights which are below the principal axis are taken as negative. So when the height is measured which is lies below the principal axis and perpendicular to the surface, such heights are taken as negative. So these are the five important sign conventions which are used to solve the problems. So these are the five conventions. Suppose if you observe in the, if the object is lies in front of the concave mirror, then in order to measure the object distance from the pole of the given concave mirror, suppose if you observe in this case, so this is the position of an extended object from the pole. So to measure the object distance from the center of the pole, so in the case of concave mirror, the object distance is always taken as negative. So the object distance is always taken as negative, that is minus u. If the image is formed in front of the concave mirror, which is called as real and inverted image, then we can take the image distance. The image distance which is measured from the pole is also taken negative. So that is equal to minus v in the case of if the mirror forms real inverted image. If the concave mirror forms a virtual erect image which lies behind the mirror, Then in that situation, the image distance V should be taken as positive, which is lies behind the mirror. In such cases, the image distance to be taken as positive. So these are the sign conventions to be applied for solving the problems. Clear? Now we derive the important relation, which is very important for public examination. That is mirror equation. What is mirror equation? The relation between focal length, radius of curvature, and object distance and image distance is called mirror equation. So that is mathematically represented as 1 by f is equal to 1 by u plus 1 by v. So by using a simple diagram and use of ray diagrams, we can derive the relation mirror equation 1 by f is equal to 1 by u plus 1 by v. Mirror equation. So what is the mathematical equation? 1 by f is equal to 1 by u plus 1 by v. So this is the mirror equation. How we derive the mirror equation? So the equation which explains the relation among focal length, object distance and image distance. So in order to derive this relation, we use a simple diagram. So this is a concave mirror. So this is principal axis. This is called pole. We consider an extended object. So AB is an extended object. So A dash, B dash, this is focus. So this is the simple diagram used to derive the relation. Here observing that, so P is the pole, F is the principal focus and C is the center of curvature of the given concave mirror. We kept an object AB beyond the radius of curvature, that means point C. So it forms a real, inverted and diminished image which is lies in front of the concave mirror. So by applying the sign convention, we derive the relation 1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. So with the help of ray diagram, we can derive the equation. So here we consider three rays which are emanating from the point A. The first one is a parallel ray which is parallel to the principal axis. Means AM is a light ray which is parallel to the principal axis. So when it strikes on the reflecting surface of concave mirror, according to the rules of ray diagram, when a ray strikes on the reflecting surface that is parallel to principal axis, is always passing through principal focus. So after reflection, the ray is passing through focus. which is represented like this. So MF is the reflected ray which is passing through the principal focus of the incident parallel ray AM. And we can consider the second ray. So the second ray is strikes at the point of pole. So again we can, when a ray which strikes at the point of pole obliquely, it reflects symmetrically, that obeys the laws of reflection. That means whatever the angle of incidence here, that should be equal to the angle of reflection. Means angle I is equal to angle R. So this is the ray which is obliquely reflected in the direction, this is, let us say, PQ. And the final ray is which is passing through the center of curvature. So when the ray passes through center of curvature, it retraces its path in the same direction. So this is the direction of the incident light ray coming from point A, passing through center of curvature, and strikes on the reflecting surface and retraces its path in the same direction. So the three rays meet at this point and form a real inverted image which is smaller size, represented A dash and B dash. So here we can write, so A dash B dash is inverted real image. Real and inverted image. And AB is the object distance. Let's represent the what is object distance, what is image distance, what is focal length, what is radius of curvature. Here we can observe in that the distance between the center of the sphere to the pole is called nothing but radius of curvature. So this is radius of curvature. And the distance between the focus and the pole is equal to focal length. And the distance from the object to the center of the pole is equal to object distance u. And the distance between the pole and the image is represented as v. So this is equal to. So these are the representations of object distance, image distance, focal length and radius of curvature. Radius of curvature. So this is the radius of curvature. Then we observe in that A, B, C and A dash, B dash, C are two triangles which are said to be similar. So we can observe in the diagram like this. So this is the diagram of triangles. So A, B, C. This is inverted image. A dash, B dash. So this is angle 90. This is also angle 90. So this angle 90. And this angle is also 90. So these are alternating opposite angles. So depending upon the angle and side, the two triangles are said to be similar. So we can consider the first case, triangle ABC and triangle A' B' C are similar. Okay? ABC triangle, A'B'C are similar. According to the property of similarity, so the ratio of the sides of the two triangles should be always equal. So we can take AB of the triangle ABC by the triangle A'B'C, we can take the A'B'. So we can write AB by A dash B dash is equal to BC by B dash C. So we can write BC by B dash C. So this is the first equation. Clear? Coming to the second triangle, that means ABP, one triangle, and another one A dash, B dash, P. These two triangles are also said to be similar. So we can draw the two triangles. So this is ABP triangle. Second one is. So this is ABP triangle, and the second one is. So this is A dash, B dash triangle. So these two angles are equal. So this is angle of incidence. This is angle of reflection. So I is equal to R according to the laws of reflection. So this is the ray which strikes the pole obliquely having the same angle of incidence and same angle of reflection. So these two are equal. So this is 90 degree. This is 90 degree. These two angles are equal. Again, angle inside, the two triangles are said to be similar. Then we can take the second similarity of the two triangles. The first triangle is triangle ABP and triangle A dash, B dash, P are similar. So we can take the proportional ratio should be always equal. Then we can write AB. So AB by A dash, B dash is equal to, we can write AB, A dash, B dash. So we can write PB by PB dash. So this becomes PB by PB dash. This is called equation 2. So from equation 1 and 2, from equation 1 and 2, LHS are equal. LHS are equal. So compare right hand side values. So we can write PB by PB dash is equal to BC by B dash C. Then we can find the PB, PB dash, BC, B dash C in terms of U, R, F and B. So PB means, here we can observe from the diagram, PB is nothing but object distance. So in place of PB, we can simply write U. But by applying the sign convention, PB is equal to minus U. The first rule, all the distance are measured from the pole, and the distance which are measured in the opposite direction of incident light. So we are measuring in the opposite direction of the incident light. Light is moving in this direction, but we are measuring from P to B. So this becomes minus U. And similarly, PB dash. PB dash is nothing but the image distance. So by applying sign convention, so we can write minus U. So what is radius of curvature? This is also equal to minus R. So PC is also equal to minus R. What about focal length? That means PF. PF is also equal to minus F. So these are the sign conventions to be applied in this diagram. Then substitute the values in this equation. So PB means we can write minus U by PB dash means minus V. That is equal to BC can be write in terms of known values. So BC means this is BC. This is BC. So BC can be written as PB minus PC. So this becomes PB minus PB minus PC. By what about B dash C? Here also we can write B dash C. So B dash C can be written as PC minus PB dash. So So this can be written as PC minus PB dash. Okay, then substitute the values of PB, PC and PB dash. You can write this is equal to PB means minus U, PC means minus R, minus of minus by PC means minus R again, minus PB dash means minus of minus by applying the sign convention. So finally, this minus minus cancel, it becomes U by V. So this is minus U plus R by minus R plus V. Okay, so on cross multiplication, we can write U multiply minus R plus V is equal to V multiply minus U plus R. So expand the bracket terms. So minus UR plus UV is equal to minus UV plus VR. So minus V U is taken to righteous. So this becomes 2UV is equal to, this brings towards the right side. So VR plus UR. So dividing the entire equation by dividing entire equation by UVR. So we can dividing the entire equation by UVR. So we can dividing this equation. So 2UV by UVR and VR by UVR plus UR by UVR. So cancel UV, numerator and denominator. Cancel VR and cancel UR. Finally, we get 2 by R is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. So 2 by R is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. But we know the value of R in terms of focal length. So R is equal to 2F. So in place of R, we can simply substitute. So 2 by R means 2F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. So cancel 2. And finally, we get 1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. So this is the mirror equation. 1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. So in order to observe the formation of real inverted image, we consider three rays. One is the ray AM parallel to the principal axis passing through focus, which is represented by MF. And the second ray is taken as the ray which is strikes at the pole, obliquely reflected with same angle of reflection. And the third ray is which is passing through center of curvature. It is retraced the path in the same direction. So the three rays are intersecting at this point, which forms a real and inverted image, A dash, B dash. So by applying the sign convention and the consideration of the two similar triangles, we can derive the relation between focal length, object distance and V. Clear? So this is the mirror equation. 1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. Now, what is magnification of the given mirror, whether it is concave mirror or convex mirror? Magnification means what is the size and where the image is formed with respect to the object. In order to observe the size of the image with respect to object, that gives the magnification of either concave mirror or convex mirror. So what is the mathematical equation of magnification, and how we can define the definition of magnification? Let's define what is magnification of a concave mirror or convex mirror. Magnification means to compare the size of the image with respect to the size of the object, whether it is a real inverted image or virtual erect image with respect to the real object or virtual object. Let's define the definition of magnification. Magnification means the ratio of size of the image to the size of the object is called magnification. So that can be written like this. So magnification is equal to, so the ratio of size of the object. Size means here we can also take height. The ratio of size of the image to the size of the object. Size of the object is called magnification. Is called magnification. So magnification is represented by letter M. So M is equal to size of the image represented by H suffix I, size of the object represented by H 0. So we can write H I by H 0. We can apply the same convention. So the height of the object is measured above the principal axis, always positive. The height of the images or objects measured below the principal axis are taken as negative. Hence we can write H I is negative because it is lies below the principal axis. So we can write this is minus H I. So this is positive plus H naught. So from the diagram we can observe that, so this is the diagram in which we observe the height of the object H naught and height of the image which is formed by the concave mirror. So this is H naught, this is HA. These two triangles are similar, already we explained in the derivation of mirror equation. According to similarity we can write the values of H naught, HA in terms of the values of object distance and image distance. So PB is nothing but, so PB is equal to object distance which is measured in the opposite direction of incident light minus, and PB dash is equal to minus V. And we can write H naught is equal to positive and HA is equal to negative. So these are the side conventions. Then write the value of magnification in terms of U and V. So we can write from the triangles, so take the two triangles, that is ABP and triangle A'B'P are similar. Take the same side ratio proportional to each other. So AB, so this can also be written as, so height of the image means we can write A dash B dash. So minus of A dash B dash by height of the object means AB. So we can write the value of A dash B dash by AB in terms of U and V. So from the two triangles we can write A dash B dash, smaller triangle. So A dash B dash by AB is equal to, so A dash B dash means PB dash is equal to PB. So we can write PB dash by by P. Then we can write what is value of P V dash. P V dash is equal to minus V. So this is minus V. This is minus V. So we can write minus V by V. So A dash B dash by AB is equal to minus. So this is minus V minus V. This becomes V by V. Substitute the value of V dash by AB in this equation. Then we can write M is equal to HI by H naught is equal to minus V by V. So this is the magnification of concave mirror. M is equal to height of image by height of object, that is equal to minus of image distance by object distance, minus of, so this is image distance by object distance. Image distance by object distance. This is the formula for magnification of concave mirror. Then the value of magnification is expressed in terms of focal length f and image distance, and focal length f and object distance. Later, when we say that the image formed by the concave mirror is real inverted depending upon the value of m, magnification. When the image is said to be virtual erect depending upon the value of m, whether it is magnified means enlarged or smaller size with respect to the object. That can be also explained based on the value of magnification. So first we write the value of m in terms of, so magnification m in terms of f and object distance u. Okay, so we can write. So what is the mirror equation? 1 by f is equal to 1 by u plus 1 by v. But magnification is equal to minus v by u. Simply we can dividing minus v throughout the equation. Then what happens? It becomes minus v by f. This is minus v by u. This becomes 1. Okay? Then we can write this implies minus v by u. And bring the minus 1 towards left. So plus 1 minus v by u. So take the LCM. Therefore, m is equal to minus v by u is equal to LCM f minus v by u. So this is the one formula which is used to calculate the magnification or focal length or image distance depending upon the given data. So m is equal to minus v by u, that is equal to f minus v by f. And also you can write the second one in terms of f and u. Simply we can eliminate the value of v. Then we can write finally magnification m is equal to minus of v by u, and that is equal to f by f minus v. This is the formula used to write the magnification value, f by f minus u. Simply we can use the mirror equation of 1 by f is equal to 1 by u plus 1 by v. Eliminate the value of v and finally we get f by f minus u. So this is the definition of magnification and the value of magnification in terms of f and u and v and Okay. So basing on the value of magnification, the nature of the image is also explained. How we explain the nature of the image? So that can be explained. It is nature of image. First one is, suppose if m is equal to, let us say, -2. If the magnification of the given mirror is -2, then the image formed by the mirror is real and inverted. Real and inverted, which is observed in the case of concave mirror. So this is concave mirror, this is real object, and A dash B dash is the real inverted image of the real object, which is lies in front of the mirror. So if the magnification is -2, then the image is real and inverted. Suppose if m is given -2, so this is real and inverted image formed by concave mirror. Here the numeric value 2 gives the image size is equal to 2u, means image is twice of the object. So this is the reference we can explain basing on the negative or positive and the numeric values. And we can take the second case. If m is equal to positive, then the image is virtual and erect. Virtual and erect means the image is formed behind the mirror in the case of concave. So the concave mirror forms a virtual and erect mirror if the magnification is positive. If it is having value 3, then the size of the virtual image is 3 times the size of the object. So basing on the positive and negative values of magnification, we can clearly explain the nature of image. Okay? So this is the definition of magnification. Let's solve one problem basing on the mirror equation and magnification. So the problem is like this. Find the position, nature and magnification of concave mirror of radius of curvature 15 cm when the object is placed in front of the mirror at a distance when 10 cm and B 45 cm. So when the object is kept at a distance 10 cm in front of the concave mirror of radius of curvature 15 cm, what is the nature and position? Nature means what is the distance of the image from the pole and whether it is real image or inverted image. That is the position and nature. Magnification means what is the size of the image with respect to the size of the object. So we observe in the diagram is like this. So the object is here, which is equal to 10 cm. So this is the given data. So we solve the first problem. So u is equal to 10 cm. So this is given, u is equal to 10. So what is the size of the image and the nature of the image? And radius of curvature is also given. So this is the center and this is r. R is equal to 15 cm. So first we write the given data. that is A. So U is equal to 10 centimeter. So apply the same conventional rule. So U is lies in front of the concave mirror. So this becomes minus. And the radius of curvature is given. R is equal to nothing but minus 15 centimeters. Okay. So we can write, from this we can write the value of focal length. Why? Because R is equal to 2m. That is equal to minus 15. Therefore, focal length F is equal to 7.5 centimeters. 15 by 2, that is equal to 7.5 centimeters. So what is the value of V? What is the position of image formed by the concave mirror? So we can write from mirror equation, we can write 1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. So here apply the same convention, U is minus 10 and F is minus 7.5. So we can write F means minus 1 by 7.5 is equal to minus 1 by 10 plus 1 by V. Therefore, 1 by V is equal to, so minus 10 becomes positive. So 1 by 10 minus 1 by 7.5. So take LCM. So that is equal to, so this is 75. 10 into 7.5, 75. So this becomes 7.5 minus 10. That is equal to, so minus 2.5 by 75. Therefore, 1 by V is equal to 25 threes. That is equal to 1 by 30 minus. So implies image distance. V is equal to image distance is equal to minus 30 centimeters. Okay? So minus 30 centimeters means the image is. So image is. So I mean the image is at a distance. At a distance 30 centimeters in front of the mirror. In front of the mirror. Minus 30 centimeters indicates that the image is at a distance of 30 centimeters in front of the mirror. Minus. So what is the magnification of the mirror? So magnification M is equal to minus of V by U. That is equal to minus. V means we get 30 by U means you get 10. So that is equal to minus 3. So here we get the magnification negative. So when M is negative, what type of image is formed? That is nothing but real and inverted image. So position means the image is formed at 30 centimeters, at a distance 30 centimeters in front of the concave mirror. And the image is real inverted image. So the nature of the image is real inverted. And what is the size of the image? The size of the image is, size of image is 3 times of size of object. So the size of the image is 3 times the size of the object. So V is equal to 3. So V is equal to 3. So this is the 3 times. Here we get V is equal to 30. Object distance is 10. So V is 3 times the size of the object. So this is the position, nature and magnification of image formed by concave weather. So for the second case, we can do the same procedure. We apply the same procedure to find the value of V and magnification, whether the image is real or virtual. Coming to the second one, here U is equal to minus 5 centimeters. In front of the mirror is given and focal length is already given, minus 7.5. So to find the position of the image, we use the mirror equation. So 1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. So 1 by F means 1 by minus 7.5 is equal to minus 1 by 10 plus 1 by V. Here V is equal to 5 centimeters. Therefore, 1 by V is equal to minus, so it becomes plus. So 1 by 5 minus 1 by 7.5. Take LCM. So we can write the LCM is 7.5. So we can write LCM is 7.5. So 5 into 1.5 minus 1. So that is equal to 0.5 by 7.5. So 1 by 15. Therefore, V is equal to 15 centimeters. So what is the position of the image? Position means the image is formed at a distance 15 centimeters behind the mirror. Behind the mirror means we get the value V positive. So this is the object distance AB, that is 5 centimeters. So this is the position of the image, which is V is equal to 15 centimeters. So this is formed behind the mirror. Then we can observe what is the nature of the mirror. Nature means we can write magnification. M is equal to minus of V by U. That is equal to, so minus of V is nothing but 15. So we can write 15 by U means minus 5. So that is equal to 3. That is equal to 3. So magnification is positive. So the mirror forms the virtual and erect image. Image is formed. So the nature of the image. So nature of image is is nothing but it forms a virtual erect image which is lies behind the mirror. So this is the position of the image, which is at 15 centimeters from the pole behind the mirror, and the nature of image is it is a virtual and erect image. And what is the magnification? That is size of image. Size of image, V is equal to 3 times of U. 3 into 5, that is equal to 15 centimeters. Here the image is 15 centimeters and the size of the object is 5 centimeters. So it is a magnified or bigger image than the size of the object.